not sure what it's going to say. I really did not want to. I really did not want to. Probably got some looks my junior year. And so I remember my first letter was like for Notre Dame. They had it delivered to the class. I looked at it. Like, is that Notre Dame? I see. So I was in the hype, get letters from Notre Dame. They weren't recruiting. They just sent me a letter. It was like a questionnaire. I'm glad. I think a lot of those things was just a high bid for talent. And they made a, got hold of my name some type of way and wanted to send me a questionnaire or something like that. During that time, the team that I wanted to go play for was the Florida Gators. And I was going to be a Gator. I had already had my Gator shop and all that stuff set. And I was going to go about celebrating after I make big plays for the Gators. But I didn't do what I was supposed to do in the classroom. So I lost that scholarship. That was devastating. So worked my behind off to get my GPA up. And then the other team that was really interested was South Carolina. So I was trying to get in contact with South Carolina to tell them, okay, I want to take the scholarship off of them. I couldn't get in touch with anybody, right? So that night, I talked to Patrick Sapp. He says to me, he said, I don't go there. You know, they don't send anybody to the pros from South Carolina, man. Let me make a phone call. So basically what he did was he called, and he basically tells them that if I come to Clemson, Ryan has to come with me. I didn't know that. I thought they really liked me. I thought I was coming here. They offered me a scholarship from all hype. And I didn't find this out, and this is crazy. I didn't find this out until like 5 years ago. So this whole time, you know, I'm thinking that, you know, I'm that dude, and, you know, Clemson wanted me, and I went there. Nope, Clemson wanted him, but they brought you along with him. So they took a chance on you because they really wanted him.
The way I played, I try to hurt me. And the way they played, they try to hurt me. So I think that me going there was a big city.
But, you know, I didn't care. I just knew that I was going to go there and do some damage. I earned my way onto the football field. Such success in the way that I was playing, the game that I played, physical brand, my movement skills, the way that I can run, and I wasn't the biggest of players, but you couldn't tell it by the way that I played. I think that that gave me an indication that, you know what, my skill set, that I have a possibility of playing on the next level. And that was the end of my sophomore year. So that is when I really recognized, you know what, not only can I play at this level, that I can play on the next level too.
Sal Palantonio in Baltimore. Sal?
Hi, Chris. I just got off the phone with Jeff Lurie, the owner of the Philadelphia Eagles. He says they're going to take a safety with this pick, Brian Dawkins of Clemson.
So that story is crazy. I had no indication that Philadelphia Eagles really liked me, but they kept everything quiet. Nobody knew that they truly wanted and they really liked me. Like, I had no clue. So nobody did. And I think they did. The story goes that they didn't want people to know that they were high on me as a potential draft pick.
Looks, he fires. It is intercepted. Intercepted by Dawkins. He can't drop. The football is loose. He was hit by Brian Dawkins on the blitz.
Transition from being a newlywed to a father to a professional football player to the breadwinner for a family and all the pressures that come along with all those. So all that stuff gets balanced now, pressure. And so anger turns to rage, turns to depression, turns to drinking, and all those things mix together. So now you're, you know, you have to find one out. So I was talking to voices in my head, and I trusted my faith. I stopped drinking beer, which I loved at the time, and that was my hope. Like, I will not consume any more of that. I will live my life for you, but that won't touch my lips again. I have not taken a sip of beer or like vodka or any of those things since my rookie year.
First of all, hallelujah! Can you feel that? Can you feel that thing? That thing that the doggone head. That thing is beating the doggone chest right now. Can you feel what's about to happen on this field, man?